Surprises, isn't it, Vince? I bet you have a few surprises for me. I know I have a few surprises for you.
Wise Guy returns next week. On Sky Movies now, a comedy drama about a strange man who withdraws into his own secure, safe world. That's The Accidental Tourist. Whilst here on Sky One, it's Love at First Sight, followed by the spine-chilling Hitchhiker.
Sunday on 21 Jump Street. In his attempt to bust a drugs ring, Booker must fight hard to protect his cover.
Is your cover blown?
Look, if you pull me out now, we'll never get another guy back in.
No one knew about the deal that night except us and Matt. And Matt ain't a narc. So it's one of you.
Yeah, or you.
And the pressure is on.
Kids know, man. They can tell. They can see right through it. Gotta bend your toes, you know?
21 Jump Street. Sunday at 7, Sky One.
Soon on Sky Movies, Bruce Willis is a reluctant hero in the box office smash.
Six or more armed with automatic weapons.
This channel is reserved for emergency calls only.
Do I sound like I'm ordering a pizza?
Die Hard.
Jack Nicholson.
Who are you?
Just your average horny little devil.
The Witches of Eastwick.
Welcome to another edition of Thunderdome.
In a world without rules, praise on your side.
Ain't we a pain?
Mel Gibson and Tina Turner, Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome. Melanie Griffith.
There is no paper in this stall. Get me some.
Harrison Ford and Sigourney Weaver.
Maybe I just don't like you.
Me?
Nah. Working Girl. Some called her mad. Others called her a legend. The true story of one woman's fight to save the gorillas in the mist. Call this number now to order your decoder and viewing card. Because without it...
Kitty Cat has changed. It still has all the protein and all the vitamins your cat needs for balanced nutrition. But now it's chunkier and tastier. And with three new varieties.
Now this is a true story. In 1977, a well-known psychic devised an ingenious way to show off his powers. Having been blindfolded, he set out to negotiate his way through the streets of Ilford in a car. Things went extremely well for the first couple of yards. Then he drove into the back of a police van. That really takes the biscuit, Maestro. So we are delighted to award you the Order of the McVitie's Digestive, struck from golden wheat meal, because when you take the biscuit, it has to be McVitie's.
There she is, kids.
Wow, you were cute back then.
Oh, thanks, Bri. I think.
Now I see why you married Willie. You were dizzy. Yikes! Hey, where'd you get that shirt?
It was the 60s, Alf. Those clothes made a statement.
Yeah, I dressed in the dark.
Monday at 7:30 on Sky One, man. Good vibes with Alf.
The master of love, Bruno Brooks.
Well, another night of passion here on your telly. Yes, welcome along to Love at First Sight yet again here on Sky One. And as ever, we'll be asking some very personal
and revealing questions where only the contestants know the answers. We're trying to match people up here. We're trying to get people to fall in love at first sight. And we do pretty well on the whole. Of course, one of our lucky couples might be going on a very romantic trip known as a love trip. Yes, on cue as ever. Terrific. And here's the lady who'll be on cue. Would you welcome back Helen? Love the jacket.
Thank you. Very military oriented.
It is, isn't it? Yes.
Military bossy tonight.
You're going to be what?
Bossy.
Oh, bossy.
Yeah.
Oh, you're always bossy. I mean, you wouldn't.
Well,
change.
More so than normal, I think.
Oh, yeah. Well, I've got to behave
myself.
You're
in for a hard time, yeah.
Okay then. Right. Well, let's bring on the girls. There they are. Good there, hello to the girls. Who do we have, Helen?
Lynette is from Knutsford, Cheshire, but did her grooming course make her a better horse rider? Deborah is from Sheffield, and she's about to appear in Greece. Lynn is from Liverpool, and in her spare time, she's in a band called Hold On.
Hey. There's more rock and roll on the way, and here comes the fellas. Here they come. Okay.
John is a restaurant manager from London who believes when the going gets tough, the tough goes shopping. Gareth is a carpet fitter from Leicester who likes ladies of a certain size. Jeremy is from London and is studying languages. Guess what? He wants to be an interpreter.
Well, there you are. What about first impressions, ladies? I mean, are you impressed so far? It's the first time you've seen them.
You
don't have to if you don't want to. How are you, Lynette?
I'm fine, thank you.
Now, you're a model, aren't you?
Not at the moment, but that's what I'm trying to do, yeah.
Yes, and you've had a very special grooming, I'm told. Is this the horse riding?
It's not got to do with the horses, no, they're quite separate. The grooming is part of becoming a model.
Oh, I see.
It is the basis.
That
yeah.
kind of grooming.
Yeah.
All right. And how are you, Deborah?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. Well, let's see, a little bit about yourself. You appeared in Greece, surely not the film itself?
Not quite the film, the stage version.
The stage version. I can just see all the lads now singing You're the One That I Want a bit later on. Hello, Lynn.
Hiya.
Now, you're in a rock and roll band, are you?
I am, yeah.
Would you like to give us a bit of a song?
Do I have to?
Yeah, would you like her to sing? Yeah! Come on, give us a quick blast.
Well, actually, they bet me to see if I would sing today, so I'm going to prove you wrong. This will be singing tomorrow, right, if I get a perfect match. Must have been love, but it's over now.
Yes, excellent, yeah. Very good. So, you know, if EMI are watching CBS and part, you know, the rest of them, probably a record contract on the way there. So, who we got over there? We got John. Hello, John.
How do you do?
And Helen tells us that you like going shopping.
Yes, love it.
In the supermarkets.
Yep.
Ever left a lady on the shelf, have you?
No.
No. You're not off your trolley?
No.
And all the other ones have come out, yeah? And how are you, Gareth?
Howdy.
A carpet fitter.
That's right, yeah, one of the best.
Are you really?
Yes.
Yeah. Which is best, felt underlay or rubber underlay?
Well, I would say background behind a good lay is the grit.
Fine. Jeremy. Hi. Nice one, guy. What about you, Jeremy? Now, you're into languages, aren't you?
I sure am.
And you want to be an interpreter.
That's right.
Which is your best language?
French at the moment.
French.
Oui. Ooh, je préfère le français.
Et toi? Non capisco.
No.
That's Italian, isn't it? I actually learned algebra at school. I can't actually speak a word of that either. Yeah. Okay, well, nice to see you. I think it's about time we found out a bit more about each other. So Helen's got some questions here. Helen, as usual, you can tell me where I'm going to start.
Let's start with a Frenchman.
Oh. The beach, Jeremy, the beach you've travelled miles to get to turns out to be a nudist beach. Do you, one, do you stay there but keep your clothes on? Two, do you strip off? Or three, do you leave immediately? Which one would you do?
I'll strip off.
Just like that?
Just like the locals, yep.
All the lot. Be honest with me now, have you ever actually sunbathed on a nudist beach?
No, I haven't.
But would you like to?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Alone or with somebody else?
With somebody else.
All right. Yeah. Well, it tells us a lot about Jeremy, actually. Well, go on. How would you choose? Go for one, two, or three. Stay, but keep your clothes on. Two, strip off, or leave immediately. Go on, press your buttons. Let's see. that we get here. I don't believe it! Everybody in Stripper! What, do you think there should be more nudist beaches in this country? What do you think, Deborah? Do you think there should be more nudist beaches?
Yeah, if you can't beat them, join them.
Have you ever been on a nudist holiday or anything like that?
Unfortunately.
Would you actually fancy that?
Mm.
What about you, Lynn?
I wouldn't mind.
Yeah? I mean, what song would you sing if you were there on the beach, nude to everybody who was sunbathing there? There must be one.
Oh, well.
Come and get me.
that one.
Yeah, that one. The old ones. All right, next question. Let's have a look. Okay,
hello. Right bunch here, haven't we?
Yeah. John, you ready? Yep. John, when playing a board game with a new partner, would you, one, go all out to win? Would you, two, always let them win? Or three, just play it straight and see what happens? You go out to win.
Yeah.
Of course, I mean, what's the point of playing a game without you wanting to go all the way and win?
That's right.
So, do you do any gambling or anything like that?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, on the horses?
No.
No? Any other gamblers here?
Anyone?
Silly with their money? No?
I'll hold on to my money.
What about you, Jeremy?
A gambler? No.
No? But you'd fight to the very end, would you?
Yeah, surely.
Yeah. And what about you, Gareth?
Oh, the odd flutter. I'll get a few bad tips.
Go on then, choose. Which one you want to go for? Go all out to win, two, always let them win, or just play it straight and see what happens. Press your buttons now. One, two, or three. You'd go out to win, most of you. Except for Lynette here, who'd just play it straight and see what happens.
Yeah, honesty is the best policy, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it is. Ah, take note of that one, Sally. Honesty is the best policy. Okay, we'll go for another question. And what do you think? Should we go for...
Let's go for John.
John, right. John, I've just been for John.
Have you just been for John?
Yeah, we'll go for Lynn over there. Lynn, what is your idea of soul food? You know, soul food. Is it oysters and asparagus, two jellied eels and mash, or something else?
Well, since I'm a bit musical, I think it would be a bit more, I'm not going to sing again. something like, I don't know, think of something.
I don't know. Did you quite fancy jellied eels?
No, soul music.
Oh, soul music?
Yeah.
Oh, forget the soul food.
Yeah, well, soul music.
You mean you just want a bit of Luther Vandross and sandwiches?
Yeah.
That's what you want. Fine. What about you, Gareth? Which one would you go for? I mean, oysters, asparagus, are you into that sort of stuff?
More oysters, I think.
Yeah?
Definitely, yeah.
Go on, choose. Which one would you go for? One, two, or three? Oysters and asparagus, one. Two, jellied eels and mash. Three, another food. Jeremy, what else would you go for?
Looking to be soul, like in fish, right?
Yeah. Okay, another quick question. Let's have a look.
They're definitely going to match those two, aren't they?
Yeah, that's right. Well, you never know. Okay, Lynette, here's one for you. You decide that a dog would do wonders for your image. Do you choose one, a Rottweiler? We made two, an Afghan hound, or three, some other breed of dog. Which one would you choose?
I'd strike a medium between the Rottweiler and the Afghan and go for Doberman, I think.
Yeah.
You've got the security, but I don't think they're quite...
Just a vicious.
Yeah.
Yes, okay. Very quickly, you choose as well. One, two, or three. Would you go for a Rottweiler, an Afghan hound, or some other breed? Come on, let's have a look. Other breeds here as well. Yes, Jeremy would go for a poodle. Fine. Deborah would go for a chihuahua. And Lynn, what would you go for? What are you guessing?
Alsatian.
An Alsatian.
Yeah.
And what about you, Gareth?
Bulldog.
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 It's amazing, isn't it? Dogs look so much like their owners, but... fine, OK. We found out a little about you. That's what it's all about. So what we're going to do now is make our mind up, all right? You're going to lock your choice into Cupid, our computer. You're going to make your choice, find your ideal partner, think about it, because you can't change your mind. And we want you to choose now. Go for it. Well, they've locked their choices in the computer now. We'll have to wait a few minutes, of course, before we reveal all. And come to think of it, I wouldn't mind a bulldog. If you were to choose your own dog, which
Yorkshire
one would you go for?
Yorkshire Terrier.
Little fluffy one.
You know why?
Why?
They're like small, little, cute things.
Fine. I look like a Yorkshire Terrier. Great. All right, well, we'll see you after the break, and we will find out whether any one of our couples have fallen in love at first sight. See you in a couple of minutes.
Dad, all the kids are going to laugh at me.
Why should they?
Because it's such a daggy jumper. The colours here are too wide, the V-neck's all wrong, and it's about 10 sizes too big.
Well, Jenny, you'll grow into it.
Dad, I've only got 7 years of school left.
Jenny's not feeling too confident about her appearance.
Jenny, I'm sorry. I didn't realise your new shoes and skirt would cause you so much embarrassment.
Hey, Dad, at the new time, 7:30 Friday on Sky One.
How about this for a greasy lot of washing up?
So I thought you lot could do it today.
OK, everyone, so we'll test fairly against the best of these well-known brands, all right? To start with, both do well. But after a while, it's a different story.
Ugh, greasy.
But Fairy keeps on cutting through the grease. So just look how much more Fairy can do. Because when grease beats the rest, the best keeps going.
The most successful new car ever launched in Europe has become big in France for being big inside. Its turn of speed, amongst other things, has made it the Germans' favorite small car. And in Italy, they're drawn in ever-increasing numbers to options like its anti-lock brakes. Its success in Sweden is doubtless due to options like a quick clear windscreen. Whilst the performance of its new automatic transmission is particularly admired by the Spanish. Of course, the Fiesta has always been big in Britain, so it's nice to see it catch on over there. The Fiesta, the small car that made it big.
One, two, three.
You can't touch this.
Oh, yeah. Don't forget, groove is in the heart.
Welcome back to Love at First Sight on Sky One. Isn't the tension building, ladies and gentlemen? It's building. I wonder if we've found a couple who've fallen in love at first sight. Well, this is what we're going to do now. We're going to find out with the help of Cupid, our computer, of course, who locked in all those choices just before the break. And, well, hopefully we will have a couple who might even get a chance to go on that romantic love trip. Right then, so we'll start with Deborah. You ready, Deborah? So we're going to now reveal which of these three guys over here Deborah went for. Okay, Cupid? Ooh, ah. Deborah, do you think he's surprised?
Yep.
He's not saying anything for the moment. Why did you go for him? What do you like him?
Looks tall from here, I think. Blonde.
He's only 4'10".
No.
All right, well, we'll find out whether John went for you, Deborah. So, Cupid, if you'd like to give us the answer, please. Oh, he fancies Lynette. And now we all know it. John, why did you go for Lynette?
Well, I don't know. Just lovely.
Just says it all?
Yep.
Yeah.
In one little parcel.
Are you speechless, are you?
Yeah.
The type of lady you could marry instantly.
Well, we could work on it.
I'm sure you could. Well, with a bit of luck, you'll be able to. We'll find out now whether Lynette has chosen you. And here comes the answer. Sorry about that, John. There's nothing I can do about it, mate. One of those things. So you've gone for Gareth, Lynette.
Yep.
Now tell us why. Tell Gareth why you love him so much.
I think he has an excellent sense of humour.
Yes?
Yep.
The carpet fitter. No, the bit about his grip. We can see what you like. Fine. Well, we'll see whether Gareth fancies you in a big way and whether he wants to make that grip. Cupid, give us the answer. I feel sorry for you, Lynn. So, why did you go for Lynn, Gareth?
I just thought she's great. Really.
Thanks.
A bubbly personality, shall
we? Did you like her voice?
Yeah, great. Love it. Well,
is that one of your secret passions, to be in a band as well? something to cope with?
Not really, no.
No, no. Okay, well, we'll see whether we've got a loving couple here, ladies and gentlemen. If Cupid would like to tell us which of these three guys Lynn has gone for, please. Oh, this is not fair. I'm going to be here all night. So, Lynn, you've gone for Jeremy. One good reason why you went for Jeremy, then?
His smile. He's got a lovely smile.
Yes. And Poland X are coming back in fashion, by the way.
Yeah, I was thinking about that.
Yeah, that's right. Jeremy, I'm just hoping, and so is Lynn, that you're going to get together here. Cupid, give us the answer. Let's go for it. That's fantastic news. Jeremy, come on, be honest now. Why was Lynn the lady for you?
Who could resist being serenaded on TV? I mean, come on.
Yeah. Yes, it does. It
and
takes...
And the legs and the body.
A lot of bottles to do that. Well, I'm sure that Lynn is the right choice for you. So you'll be back and playing on the Love Board, of course, and going for those prizes, which also includes the Love Trip. And that's about it. So come and join us here on the stage. Our love couple. Give him a hug. Commiserations to our other four contestants on the stage. I'm sure you'll agree they were great sports. Give them a nice round of applause. They were great. They will all get one of my special passion pins here, a rarity in themselves. So here we are. They're off to dinner. So where are they going to go, Helen?
Jeremy, you can play the gallant St. George to Lynn at the St. George Cantonese restaurant over an exotic and oriental meal in serene and relaxing surroundings. You'll discover the mysteries of the Orient and each other.
So, Jeremy.
Yep.
And you thought you were going to go home tonight, but no.
I certainly did, but no.
You're going out for dinner. Now, of course, the main thing is, the thing to remember is that, okay, you're going to have a nice slap-up meal and so on, but get to know each other, because when you come back, you need to know more about each other, because that will decide how many prizes you can go for on the Love Board, okay? We want you to win that Love Trip, don't we? We really do. So congratulations, go and enjoy yourself, and we'll see you next time. Give a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Love is still in the air, because do you remember when this couple fell in love at first sight?
It's the cleavage, the whole body. The what? It's the hair down, from the eyes down, it's just gorgeous.
It's just a trendy dress, and those eyes are absolutely gorgeous.
Melanie, who was the sales executive, and Simon was the French polisher, and you've guessed, they're back on Love at First Sight. Here they are. Come and join us.
Hi.
Holding hands.
Yeah.
Lovely. I see a bit of romance here. Did you have a nice night that night?
Fantastic night, yeah.
it was a Chinese restaurant, as I remember.
That's right,
Have you noticed in the Chinese restaurants, they always have these big round tables, don't they? Did that get in the way at all?
Just a bit.
We were trying to get across.
Yeah,
we were trying to get across there, but we never actually touched.
You didn't? That's a bit of a shame.
Went straight round and sat next to her.
I hear you had a few problems with the chopsticks.
Took him half an hour to try and use it.
I got the thin end at the top and the fat end at the bottom.
Yeah. I'll tell you the honest truth. He walked into the restaurant, they gave him his chopsticks. He said, right, which one's right and which one's left? Well, I'm glad you had a good time. Hope you found out a bit about yourself. That's the main thing, because you're playing for prizes on the Love Board in 2 minutes. See you after the break. See you then.
Commencing 8 o'clock Sunday, a very special television event.
The world may be conquered on horseback, but cannot be ruled from it.
Marco Polo, the epic adventure of the young Italian who traveled deep inside a culture unknown to the outside world, where he fell in love and won the trust of the Kublai Khan.
You have been blinded by the wealth of your Khan. Everyone knows that these Mongols are a race of bloodthirsty savages.
Filmed on location in Africa, Asia, and Europe. A television masterpiece that took 4 years in the making. Starring John Gielgud, Burt Lancaster, Leonard Nimoy, Anne Bancroft, John Houseman. And introducing Ken Marshall as Marco Polo. A four-part miniseries. Marco Polo, commencing Sunday at 8 on Sky One.
Muffin! Notice anything different about me?
Yes, well, the stupid smug grin's the same as usual.
No, Mustard, Mustard.
A medallion, yes, very tasteful.
Actually, this astute financial investment was a free introductory offer from these people.
Sproggett and Sylvester? Never heard of them.
Oh, smart cookies. They could do a lot for you.
Yes, well, actually, I got my little lot for the Alliance and Leicester.
Yeah, you don't want to get involved with these fly-by-night financial cowboys, Mustin.
This is one of the biggest building societies in the country.
Size isn't everything, is it, Mustin?
No. But they've got things like phone banking.
No. Sproggett and Sylvester have got phones coming out of their ears.
Well, I bet they haven't got a cash card that you can use in other people's machines.
Mustin, this card could get me into Fort Knox.
Now then. Right.
Mustin!
You get a dafter investor at Sproggett and Sylvester. Encrusted with whole hazelnuts from the Orient. Studded with rich, dark chunks of smooth Belgian chocolate. And baked in a crumbly, melt-in-the-mouth biscuit as only McVitie's know how. New McVitie's Boasters. Find them a good home.
It's live, it's funny, it's dangerous, it's party time, it's Saturday night!
Hello again and welcome back to Love at First Sight on Sky One, way away from that round table in the Chinese restaurant and those chopsticks and everything too. The love hearts on the board and somewhere on there, as you know, is that love trip. Yeah. And hopefully Simon and Melanie are going to be going on that love trip. Now, six questions, three apiece, the first one to you, Melanie, okay? Right. Now, what is Simon's most annoying habit? What is his most annoying habit? Is it cracking his knuckles, picking his nose, or another habit, all right? Sam is just writing it down. He's been extremely honest about this one. And I want you to give me the right answer. So you may answer now. Cracking his knuckles, picking his nose, or another habit, which is?
Cracking his knuckles.
Cracking his knuckles. No, picking his nose, I'm afraid. please, not here. Okay, who does she consider to be a sex symbol? Plenty of time to answer, because you've got to write it down. So write down who you consider to be a sex symbol, okay? Think about it. Let's have a look. Hang on, what do you think? Have a good time? Plenty of time to think.
Mel Gibson.
I don't think that was right, no. Patrick Swayze, I think she was going to go for there, weren't you?
Sorry.
Yeah, that was a good guess. Never mind. If you insisted on paying the bill at a restaurant, Melanie, would he be embarrassed or would he be delighted? Scribble away, would it be embarrassed or would it be delighted?
Delighted.
You think you'd be delighted, would you? Yeah, that'll do. Get your first love heart. What colour wine does Melanie most enjoy? Think about this just for a second. I want you to write it down. Pick up your pen and write it down. There can only be three colours, surely. Unless you come from Mars. Okay, what do you think it is? Remember the dinner? Remember the dinner?
White.
It was white, yeah. Why is Simon likely to become famous? Is it one, because of his looks, two, because of his humour, or three, because he's just, you know, so talented? He's just so talented, this guy. So, which do you think? His looks, his humour, his talent? The answer is?
His humour.
His humour, yeah, good. We're getting there. That means you've got three love hearts and hopefully a fourth. On a foreign holiday, would Melanie sunbathe topless? Now, hang on a second. Write down the answer, Melanie. I want you to be very honest here, like you were at that dinner. All right, you told him all those things. Would she sunbathe topless, yes or no?
Most definitely, yeah.
Most definitely, yes. Great. We got four love hearts. So that's pretty good. Not bad at all. Well done. Obviously, that dinner out was all worth it in the end. We're now going to explain exactly what tonight's love trip is all about. It's a holiday of a lifetime you would never forget to the wonderful island of Hawaii. And you can use up some of that excess energy by learning how to water ski or just laze about on a boat. After a week soaking up the sun in this Pacific paradise, you could have memories forever of your love trip.
Well, that is really a fantastic holiday in Hawaii. That's absolutely amazing. What do you think about that? And there are the love trip tickets to prove it. Great stuff. How do you fancy going off to Hawaii, Helen?
Oh, I'd love to. Sun, sea, sound and romance.
Oh, sounds great, doesn't it? You ever been to Morecambe by any chance?
Never.
You know, I used to be an AA man on Morecambe Beach. Going amongst all the courting couples going, hey, 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 come on. They were good times, they really were. Well, hopefully you will get on that love trip, because that's what it's all about. And let me see, how many hearts have you got all together now? I'd say you've got about four, was it four hearts? You got
four. Right, yeah.
Four, that's good. 4 seconds a heart, which means you've got 16 seconds to get those prizes, and your time starts now. Oh, no. The broken heart. Mm-hmm. As you know, as anyone who plays the game knows, the moment you hit the broken heart, that means the game is all over. Such a shame. Never mind. That's the problem, you see. All the prizes are hidden behind there. We've got the massage, all sorts of different prizes, and the love trip itself, which was in Hawaii. Mm-hmm. I tell you what, Helen, would you like to tell me where the love trip was?
Should I tell him? Yes, number seven.
Number seven. If you'd have gone for a lucky seven, you see. There we are. It will be there. Oh, never mind. Give him a big R, ladies and gentlemen. A nice round of applause. Will you be seeing each other again?
We might do, yeah.
Well, I hope you will, I'm sure. I know you did get on well together and you enjoyed your Chinese meal and everything else.
Yes,
so,
did.
Thanks very much for playing the game. Thank you for watching. Join us again on Love at First Sight to find out if even more couples fall in love. We'll go and see Helen. Good night. Bye-bye. Would you like to appear on Love at First Sight? If so, simply drop us a line and we'll send you an application form. Write to Action Time, P.O. Box 121, Manchester, M60 1EX. You never know, you might just meet the love of your life and win some super prizes into the bargain. That's Action Time, P.O. Box 121, Manchester, M60 1EX.
Nowhere to hide. There's three wise guys and they're called Riptide.
I'll see if I can rent a helicopter. We'll pick up some firepower. We'll beat them out there, okay? Now, how's that sound? Dangerous.
So excited. Missing persons, phone calls in the middle of the night.
Getting the drop on the bad guys. Taking the lid off another high-flying adventure. It's the Riptide Detective Agency. Friday at 8 on Sky One.
Before going to bed.
Oh, thank heaven for that. Oh, look, this big steak's here. And a... Not in front of the view.
Join us for a brand new series.
Deadly, earnest horror show.
Friday, 11 o'clock.
Only on Sky One. The most baffling mysteries are the ones that really happened.
Now on Sky One, a riveting new series that features ordinary people thrust into extraordinary cases. Crime stories, lost heirs, missing persons, mysteries that could happen to anyone, and did.
Join me, won't you, for an hour of Unsolved Mystery.
Watch the Emmy-nominated series Unsolved Mysteries, Saturday at 9 on Sky One.
That makes the assholes must have been on a double shift. You should have seen what they were throwing at me. First they load all this work on me, then they ask me to do Murray's work too.